Hey, what's going on, everybody? Chad Christian coming at you with another exciting video. I had the Google Home coming in, so I thought, you know what? It'd be really cool to do a home automation setup. So you can see I've got all my Philips Hue lighting system with motion sensors and my Nest. So today I'm going to bring you a Nest unboxing, installation, and setup video. So here we go. So now that I've got it out of the box, you can see I've got the beautiful stainless steel edition. They have stainless steel and black. Both of them look really nice. And inside the box here, we've got a screwdriver and our back plate where we can plug in our wires, plus our screws. Plus here's our manuals. Just basic information. Control it from your iPhone. And you can control this from any tablet, Android, or iOS device, which makes it really neat. Now this is the installation manual. Make sure you check it out. It does a really good job of explaining what to do in what order. As you'll see in my video, I did follow a step-by-step with this. So right there in the blue on the left-hand side, those are actual stickers that you'll see I'll put on the wires. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to turn the power off of your AC and your furnace. So go ahead and go to your fuse box and shut those off. You're going to want to take off the faceplate of your thermostat. You can see I've got a couple of screws holding the wall mount in place. You want to document which cables are in there. I actually started taking the wires off and then I remembered, oh yeah, they want me to take a picture of the way that it used to be, which I highly recommend. A, in the event that the new Nest doesn't work with your system, and B, you want to remember exactly where each wire was because that's going to correlate to how it goes into the Nest. So let me get this picture out of the way here just so we have it for future reference. And there we go. Now that I got a nice photo of it with my LG V20, which I'll leave a link below if you haven't seen that video. And so what we want to do now is I'm just using the Nest tool here to unscrew each one of these wires. They do recommend that you have, I believe it's 10 millimeters, but you'll want to check the installation guide to make sure you have enough wire stripped off so the connections can go back into place. And these are the blue labels, so each one, you know, is color-coded red, yellow, but the difference is that some of them, I believe blue and green can also have blue-green 1, blue-green 2, so you do want to make sure that you use the stickers for each of the wires that you have so that when you remove this plate, you'll be able to set it up with the Nest backplate system. Alright, now that I've got all my wires labeled, at least the ones that I want, I'm going to go ahead and unscrew this back plate. Make sure when you remove the back plate that you don't pull too hard on any of the wires. You don't want any of your wires to break because some of your older wires could be really frayed up or brittle. So just be extremely careful when you take the wires back out of this back plate. And you can see that there's been some work done on my wall here where it looks like there must have been some other older thermostats or some other things that were put into this spot. So to cover it up, the nice thing is that Nest includes a backplate which will actually cover this whole area. So let me show you what it would look like if I didn't use the Nest backplate to go along with this little control panel. So you can see there that you would see the wall and how ugly that would look. So let me grab this big giant back plate here to hide all that. You can see here that the back plate is a pretty good size, so it will cover up quite a bit. So just make sure I put my wires back in here into the hole, make it nice and neat. Now I'm just gonna push down on the face of this and it will click into place. Now what we want to do is we just want to drill this into our wall. And it does have a built-in leveler there. I don't know if you can see it just below the screw that I'm putting in. You can see the little blue built-in leveler. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in almost all the way in. And it does have some washer screws and different size for them. So it just depends on you know, how your wall is. I'm going to screw in the bottom one here. Now I'm going to fine adjust this, and then I'm going to go ahead and mount it all the way to the wall. All right, now it's time for the wires. So you can see that I only needed to label a couple of these, and I did that mostly just for you guys, but I mean, white is white, green is green, right? So I looked at the plate. Let me show you here real quick. You just push the buttons on the outside edge of where they are, and it actually opens up a little door, kind of like inserting speaker wires. That's exactly what it's like, and then it just pinches the wire. Now what's interesting here is I have this red wire. Well, red, there's an RC and then another RH, I believe, and I wasn't sure where to put it, but in the manual it says if you only have one red wire, it can go into either one to power the unit. Okay, so now that I've got all my wires in place, I'm ready to install the thermostat. And you can see with the blue leveler there that everything looks okay. And all you need to do to install the thermostat is just make sure you get it in place. There is a little socket on the bottom for its power. Push it into place, you'll hear a little click, just like that, and you're good to go. Pull the tab off. Done. Now I'm going to go back down to my breaker box, and I'm going to turn both of these back on for my furnace and my AC. Okay, now that I've gone down to my breaker box and turned everything back on, we can go ahead and set up the nest. You just use the turn dial. At first I thought, wow, what, do you just push the screen? No, sir. And then I said, well, do you push on the sides of the dial? Nope, strike two. So on the very bottom of the display unit, you can't hardly tell at all, but there's a little push button. So let me show you where that's at. Hey, third time's a charm. So there you go. Now we just need to choose what language we want it to be in. We're gonna set up our internet connection because this uses our Wi-Fi. So let me go ahead and set all this up and then show you what to do next. Okay, so it's connected now online. I'm gonna go ahead and push it. It says checking for a software update. So now if there's any firmware updates that need to be done, it's gonna go ahead and do that on your unit. Now it's going to ask what location you're in, which is pretty nice because it just grabs it from your Wi-Fi. Now we just have to tell it what kind of building that we're in and where is my thermostat located. And in this case, it's located in my dining room. So it wants to know, is it heating and cooling, which it is. And I'm not a Nest Pro, I'm just a homeowner. And the nice thing here is that it shows you which wires it has detected that you've plugged in. So make sure you now verify this with that picture you took earlier to make sure that everything is plugged in correctly. It says my system's a heating and cooling with a fan. That's correct. And then what type of fuel source am I using for my heating? So make sure this is properly set up. And in my case, I'm just using electric. And I do have central air unit, so I have a forced air unit. And the temperature, should Nest begin heating or cooling your home? Well, it's cold, I'm in Michigan, so we're gonna set that to heating. Now, this is the economy mode. It just wants to know what the lowest and highest temperatures are that you'd like to set when you're away. Let me go ahead and set these up so you can see you just turn the dial here. All right, now that I've got those set up, says my system is ready to test. You can test it now. And what would you like to test? So I'm just going to test the heating real quick. I push on the button, wait to make sure that everything is set up properly. And in about 10 seconds, my heat kicked on and I was good to go. The test was successful, so I'm going to go ahead and turn it back off. I'm done with my testing now. Let me go ahead and rotate the dial to done. Your adjustments help learn. The nice thing with the Nest is it learns over time. So as you turn your air on or off, or your heat up or down, depending on the part of day that it is or what the temperatures are like outside, the Nest will begin to learn what you're doing. Now you can also set it up to be in a program. So like right now I have it set to at night it goes down to 68 degrees and then during the day it goes to 72 degrees. But you can have it just learn what you're doing and it will adjust itself. So you can see the nice thing is it shows the temperature outside, the humidity indoors and outdoors. The cool thing with the screen is anytime you walk by, it automatically activates itself and lets you know what's going on. So that's going to do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, hit that thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next video.